Hi to the class of 90 and good luck in the future.
Thumping and the jam is pumping. Look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more. Get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you find out if you do that. Yeah.
You've gotta let him know how much I care. I'll never give up looking for my baby.
Thank you. Thank you. Please bow your head for the class prayer. Lord, Father in heaven, bless this gathering with your love to help us possess the strength to gain rightful knowledge, to achieve our goals, to love one another as we love ourselves, to live peacefully, and to carry on a safe and productive life. Lord, we thank you for this ceremony, the helpfulness and commitment of the teachers and staff, the hope that you gave us when we were in need, and this great attribute of graduation. Finally, we ask you and your Son, Jesus Christ, to answer our prayers in heaven, where you reign forever and ever. Amen.
Good morning, and welcome to the Class of 1990 Class Day presentation. It's wonderful to see parents, friends, faculty, and fellow students come to honor the achievements of the Class of 1990. On behalf of the senior class, I'd like to thank you all for the endless support you've given us throughout the years. I'm sure I speak for us all when I say that you are all greatly appreciated. I don't want to put a damper on our high spirits of the day by talking of these being our last few days together, because I don't believe that to be true. We have the upcoming graduation parties and the whole summer to be together. High school has helped many of us to build friendships that will last forever, and you can never truly lose a friend. A part of that friend will remain with you forever in spirit. For it is those who now surround you who helped you to grow up and become the person that you are today. Although all of us are not friends, there are many more of us that are. All of us are friendly enough to smile, say hello, or to lend a classmate a helping hand when needed. As your class president, I would like to say thank you to the other officers, Karen, Rhonda, and Shannon, for all the help that you've given me all year, and also to the senior representatives. I'd also like to say thank you to the advisors that I've had the pleasure of working alongside throughout high school, Mr. Silvasi, Mrs. Ellsworth, Mrs. Burnett, Mr. Baker, and Mr. Thompson. You have all been so helpful and supportive of all of us throughout the years, and also to the faculty members. Your support is appreciated by all of us also. You are an inspiration to me, as I'm sure you are to many others. To the undergraduates, I'd like to say good luck during the rest of your high school years. Make the best of them. High school is a wonderful place, and I only hope that you can all experience it the way that I have. I've made many wonderful memories, and I'm sure I will never forget. To the seniors, I say good luck, and God bless you all. I hope all of your dreams come true. Never give up, because your dreams are worth achieving. Being one of last year's nominees, it is an honor for me to present the Lions Club Undergraduate of the Year Award. This award is given each year to two outstanding undergraduates, one male and one female. These students have shown outstanding character, academic or leadership abilities, or a combination of all three. These students are nominated by the Senior Graduation Activities Committee and are selected by the Hazel Park High School faculty. Nominees, please come forward and be recognized when I announce your name, for it is just as great an honor to be nominated for this award as it is to receive it. And the nominees are Bobby Adkins, Troy Dilbeck, Jamie Duncan, Jeff Eddy, Irv Marshan, Jennifer Berrios, Mona Jabber, Kathy Jacobs, Cindy Smith, and Jenny Warner. And the winner of the 1990 Undergraduate of the Year Award goes to Jamie Duncan and Kathy Jacobs. I'd now like to introduce Mr. James Gibson, the superintendent of schools.
Good morning. Boy, this is an exciting day. You see you graduates coming down those aisles. That's exciting, and I'm sure you can relate to that. The comedian Bill Cosby maintains that there are three distinct groups that make up every graduating class. There's the, what he called the middle of the roaders, the average students, the biggest number usually, those that didn't do a great job, but didn't do a bad job either. They got the job done, and those are your middle of the roaders. Then there's your honor students, your scholars, those that we call the summa cum laudes and the magna cum laudes and the cum laudes. And of course, the other group he calls the thank you laudes. I would say this, though, that he missed one very important group that we won't miss this morning, and that's the group known as the high achievers. The class day program is dedicated to you people, those of you that went above and beyond what was expected during these high school years. In order to rise to the top of your class in your respective area of interest and expertise, it took sacrifice and self-denial and, yes, going beyond the point of comfort. And for those of you that will be receiving these awards of excellence, we wish to applaud you and compliment you on your accomplishments. Through your efforts, the level of expectation for excellent among the senior class at Hazel Park remains high. Congratulations to all of you that will be receiving these awards. In class of 1990, we want you to enjoy these next few days especially, but please be careful as we're looking forward to all of us rejoining next Thursday evening. Nice job, and again, congratulations to those of you that will be receiving special honors this morning.
Good morning. Hopefully, most of you were able to watch the class day parade. The rain did subside enough, at least for the parade time, so that people could come out, although our crowd was a little diminished this year. However, the spirit of the seniors was not dampened by the weather. The parade represents the successful completion of high school for the class of 90. The participants were creative in their designs and handiwork. It is very evident that a lot of time was spent in preparation for this event. Class of 90, may I congratulate you on a great beginning of the end. Several faculty members judge the cars based on creativity, neatness, sturdiness, and length of time spent in preparation. We have 6 cash prizes today to be awarded to the winners. First, we have something a little unusual this year, an Advisor's Consolation Award to a unique entry in our, quote, car parade, and that was car number 44R, 2 bicyclists, Donnie Allen and Sean White. I would like all winners to please step forward, and then when you're all up here, I will come down and present you with your awards. Thank you. In 5th place, with the Down with Hobbs on the top, and car number 11, Larry Day. In 4th place, with Hobbs resting on top, car number 35, Heather Scott. In 3rd place, graduation ladies, car number 2, Shannon Andre. In 2nd place, in the Hobbs Galore car, number 27, Colleen McCafferty. And in 1st place, Hobbs in Hawaii, number 20, Nicole Holton. Although I only read the name of the driver, of course I want you to know we all realize that they have lots of friends and helpers who help them get their cars ready for this. Thank you. Thank you.
It's always a pleasure to be able to present the scholarship and the various awards to each graduating class. The class of 1990 is no exception, and I'm going to recognize several members of this class. The state of Michigan sponsors a scholarship tuition grant program in three different categories. As I read each category, I would like the recipients to stand up to be recognized, and I would ask that the audience hold your applause until each section is completed. Receiving certificates for outstanding achievement in the State of Michigan Competitive Scholarship Program, Joseph Algram. Please stand. Michael Bird, Mary Culver, Angel Evangelist, Russell Hoffer, Marie Neer, Douglas Menke, Michael Marshall, Amy McMurray, Laverne Moxley, Lisa Northey, Michelle Norton, Deanna Perot, Nancy Ray, Heather Scott, James Tartamella, and Lisa Tominello. A nice round of applause for them, please. Scholarship recipients in the State of Michigan program. Again, please stand, please hold your applause. Stephen Booth, Buck Buchanan, Joseph Cifolo, Catherine Hawkins, William Jones, Christy Keaton, Kerry Loftus, Thomas McCullough, Kathleen Mulkey, Robert Navarre, Diane Parton, James Scott, Jeffrey Steelman, and Jennifer Watson. A nice round of applause for these people. Tuition grant recipients in the State of Michigan competition. Cynthia Allers, Shannon Andre, David Campbell, Keith Samer, Michelle Derringer, Gregory Garska, Sherry Hedges, Heidi Henkel, and Eve Treat. A nice round of applause for these people. Scholarships and various awards by colleges. Again, please stand when I read your name. The Detroit College of Business, Cynthia Allers, receiving a high school scholarship. Michelle Derringer, a high school scholarship, and the Michigan Business School scholarship. General Motors Institute, Shannon Andre, a General Motors truck and bus sponsorship, a Jewish War Veteran scholarship, and a Society of Women Engineers scholarship. Michigan Technological University, Heather Scott, the Hazel Park Band Booster Bud Lutholz Award. Murray State College, Angel Evangelist, the Century Club Award. Oakland University, Stephen Booth, the Student Life Scholarship. University of Hawaii, Jennifer Marsh, a four-year dance scholarship, Masonic Temple Scholarship, the George Danick Ferndale American Legion Scholarship. University of Michigan, Christy Keaton, the Regents Alumni Scholarship. Wayne State University, Merit Scholarships, Kerry Loftus, Thomas McCullough, also a Phi Beta Kappa Scholarship, Michelle Norton, a Merit Scholarship, Deanna Perot, a Merit Scholarship, Jeffrey Steelman, a Merit Scholarship, Jennifer Watson, a Merit Scholarship. A nice round of applause for these people. Thank you. The Tandy Corporation recognizes outstanding scholars across the United States. Receiving recognition for the top 2% of the seniors at Hazel Park High School, the following people. Please stand. Angel Evangelist, Christy Keaton, Carrie Loftus, Thomas McCullough, Deanna Perot, and Nancy Ray. Out of that top 2% across the country, the Tandy Technological Group select one student as the Outstanding Student Award for a Hazel Park High School graduate. The Tandy Corporation chose Miss Christy Keaton. The Society of Women Engineers, the Michigan Technological University chapter, awards a certificate of merit for the highest honors in science and mathematics to Miss Heather Scott. The Society of Women Engineers, the Detroit section, awards certificates of merit for high honors in science and mathematics to Miss Christy Keaton, Miss Carrie Loftus, Miss Nancy Ray. Each year we recognize and want to recognize those young people who have selected to join the armed services of our country. The United States Army, John Campbell, Alice Dubrow, Robert Edwards, Paul Plaza, James Tartamella, Ronald Tremonti. United States Navy, Shane Abney, Donald Allen, David Walters. United States Marines, Jason Cawthon, Joel Cawthon, Denise Charland, and Richard Spitalski. United States Air Force, Marvin Craner. A nice round of applause for these young people. We have some technology awards from the Hobart School of Welding in Ohio. Robert Forbes, please stand. Kenneth Spaulding, Sam Heath, Keith Smiley, Sam Carter, and Peter Heron. The National Vocational Technical Honor Society from the Oakland Technical Center in Royal Oak recognizes three young people, Larry Day, Kevin Fage, and Lori Menser. We have one final award. Historically, the people of Hazel Park have recognized the importance and the value of higher education. It's common knowledge that graduates of Hazel Park make significant contributions in communities throughout this country. And always remember that no matter what, you will always be a Hazel Parker. A scholarship program has been established by the City of Hazel Park to assist students who wish to pursue careers in communications. Here to present this award is the Honorable Michael Binkley, the Mayor of the City of Hazel Park. The two recipients from the class of 1990 who will receive these outstanding scholarships are David Martin and Nicole Price. Would you please come up?
At this time, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you the class valedictorians and salutatorians. First of all, our salutatorians. Our salutatorians are in alphabetical order: Angel Evangelist, Deanna Perrault, and Nancy Ray. Would they come forward, please? All three of these girls had grade point averages of 3.96. That means that during their high school careers, they received only one B, and that was in a semester class. All the rest were A's. And now I would like to introduce to you our valedictorians. They are, in alphabetical order, Christy Keaton, Carrie Loftus, and Tom McCullough. All three of these students had grade point averages of 4.00, perfect grade point averages. That means that during their high school careers, they received all A's and nothing below that. Could we have another round of applause for that accomplishment? I would like everyone to know that all six of these students here took the top designated courses in the subject area of their career interest. They also took all of the advanced courses that are required in order to be eligible for salutatorian and valedictorian honors. Speaking for the entire staff, I would like to commend all of you, both the salutatorians and the valedictorians, for your fine academic achievements. We are certainly proud of you. We would like to extend our best wishes to all of you as you pursue your academic interests next year at college. Thank you.
At this time, I would like 11 students to come forward and join Mrs. Kubek. Angel Evangelist, William Jones, Christy Keaton, Carrie Loftus, Thomas McCullough, Kathleen Mulkey, Michelle Norton, Nancy Ray, Heather Scott, Jeffrey Steelman, Jennifer Watson. These students are receiving the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. To qualify, they must have taken a strong academic program, attained at least a B-plus average, and scored at or above the 80th percentile on the American College Test. Each of these is an accomplishment in itself. To obtain all three is commendable. For their accomplishments, at this time, they are receiving a lapel pin, a presidential letter, and a certificate signed by the President of the United States. I will read three lines from the letter. By taking full advantage of your educational opportunities, you have shown the judgment, character, and determination necessary to succeed in all your endeavors. I commend you all for setting an outstanding example of scholarship. Barbara joins me in saluting you for a job well done and in wishing you continued success in the future. Signed, George Bush, President of the United States. Let's join the president and congratulate all these students.
It is a pleasure for me this morning to represent the business department in recognizing an outstanding business student from this graduating class. The Best Business Student Award is given to a student who has taken 2 semesters of typewriting, 1 year of bookkeeping, 1 year of shorthand, 2 semesters of computers, and 2 semesters of additional business courses. Obviously, the young lady we selected for this award is skillful in office procedures, but she has so much more to offer. She is what we consider an excellent recipe for a successful employee, because she blends together extremely well the ingredients that employers look for: excellent attendance, very responsible, a genuine liking for people, flexibility, and a willingness to put in the extra effort to get things done. Ladies and gentlemen, our best business student, Tammy Wilmoth.
Good morning, seniors. This morning, it is my genuine pleasure to recognize students in the class of 1990 who excel in the area of computer science. First, I would like to honor 4 of your classmates who were hand-selected to take the advanced placement test in computer science. These students worked hard on their own time to prepare for this grueling exam, which may result in college credit. The students were Adam Hempstead, Michelle Norton, Jennifer Watson, and Robert Winchell. We applaud your efforts. Next, I would like to present the winner of the Computer Science Award. To qualify for this award, a student must take computer literacy, a full year of programming, and computer applications. In addition to high achievement, the student must exhibit qualities which compute to success, not only in school, but in the business world as well. This year's class has produced many excellent candidates, and I had the unenviable task of selecting just 1 student for this award. This year's recipient has excelled academically and in the area of service. In addition to fulfilling the requirements, he has taken independent study in computer science and spends every lunch period tinkering in the computer lab. He has matured a great deal in the 3 years that I've known him. He can answer most any question that comes his way, and he demonstrates a genuine interest in the field of computer science. Please congratulate the recipient of the Computer Science Award, Adam Hempstead.
Congratulations, class of 1990. The Language Arts Department would like to present the English Award to an outstanding English student. The recipient of this award has earned an A in all of her English classes. She has also taken all of our most challenging courses: English Literature, World Literature, Advanced Composition, Advanced Grammar Term Paper, and Creative Writing. Not only has this fine young lady received high marks for her studies, she has also put her knowledge and skills into action. She has worked on the yearbook in the Hazel Parker. She has been an active member of the Language Club. She has entered several writing contests and is currently the Vice President of National Honor Society. In the fall, this student will be attending Murray State College, studying pre-med and majoring in biology. It is my pleasure to present this award to Angel Evangelist.
The science department traditionally decides which students have excelled in their science endeavors throughout their years at Hazel Park High School. The number of awards given depends upon the number of qualified candidates. All candidates must have taken biology, chemistry, and physics, and must have achieved high grades in these classes. All of our award winners this year have had these science classes as well as second year classes in either chemistry, biology, or both. The eight science teachers have carefully chosen three students among several outstanding nominees. I will be presenting two of these awards to students that I feel very fortunate to have had in my physics class. The first award to be presented is the Bosch and Lohm Honorary Science Award. This award is presented to a student who has demonstrated conspicuous achievement in the study of science, possesses good character, and superior intellectual promise in the field of science. Our recipient this year is a young man who embodies all of these qualities. His A average in classes ranging from chemistry and physics to advanced electrical technology and chemistry 2, combined with his probing curiosity, clearly demonstrates his conspicuous achievement. This exceptional young man even chose a difficult science topic for his term paper. His excellent character is evidenced by frequent involvement with his church and community, his membership in National Honor Society, and in his general deportment. He plans to pursue a career in electrical engineering at the University of Detroit, where I am certain he will prove his superior intellectual promise in the field of science. It is with great pleasure that I would like to present the Bosch and Lohm Honorary Science Award on behalf of the Science Department to Greg Garska. The second highest award given by the Science Department is the Class of 1961 Award. This award was established to honor the student who not only excels in science, but also has demonstrated significant achievement in the study of math and foreign language. This would seem to be a rather difficult task. However, this year's recipient of the Class of 1961 Award has received so many A pluses in all of these areas, he makes the task seem simple. This young man is so gifted that indeed what is difficult for many is in fact simple for him. Yet he maintains a keen interest and attention in all of his classes, asking questions that have given more than one of his teachers reasons to ponder. His credits include high achievement in chemistry, physics, biology, all advanced math classes, through calculus and advanced Spanish. This exceptional young man also manages to be an outstanding contributor to Hazel Park High School's track team as well. Wayne State University will indeed appreciate this gem of a student planning to pursue a career in engineering. I'm very pleased to present the Class of 61 Award to Tom McCullough.
The Science Student of the Year Award, as Mrs. Buckley already explained, has certain criteria which are similar to the other two awards. It is given to someone who is interested in a science career and has indicated so by taking biology, chemistry, and physics. This year's winner also took other classes, including my advanced biology class. In this class, she was by far the most brilliant student. In addition, she was one of the most polite and friendly members of the class. For these reasons, I am pleased to be the one to present this year's highest science award to a young lady everyone loves, Christy Keaton.
With the assistance of Mr. Bolt, I would like to present the Math Award. The math award is given to the outstanding math student as determined by the mathematics staff. This year, we've decided that two students are worthy of this award. I would like to present the math awards to Tom McCullough and Christy Keaton.
Wonderful community, the art department is able to award four students, honoring them for their excellence in the fine arts. Will these students come forward? Diane Faggio, Dawn Lay, Shiloh Martin, and Jennifer Spitzer.
On behalf of the high school coaching staff, it is my pleasure to present the Female and Male All Sports Award. This award was first presented in 1945 and is the oldest of the athletic awards. Both athletes have well above a 3-point grade point average, and both have participated in sports throughout their 3-year high school careers. Our female winner lettered 3 years in basketball, volleyball, and softball, and earned honorable mention all SMA honors. She's an outstanding leader, diligent worker, very fine young lady, will be attending the University of Michigan this fall, Ms. Kathleen Mulkey. Our male winner has earned all SMA honors and has been a state qualifier in cross country and was captain of the cross country and track teams. He's a fine sportsman, an outstanding young man, will be attending Oakland University in the fall, Tracy Riley.
Congratulations, class of 1990. You have many fine athletes from which to be proud, and I'm sure you'll be very proud of your most dedicated female athlete from this 1990 class. I wish I had time to really describe the progress that this young lady made in her athletic career. I think it's enough to say that being a track and cross-country runner, it's description enough for me to say to you and to the audience that she started at one end of the line, and that was not the best end of the line, and she ended up as a captain, a leader, an inspiration, and a medal winner on this spring's track team. This year's recipient will be attending Macomb Community College next fall. She wishes to pursue a career in elementary education, and she'll be a great one. I'm proud to announce to you that Miss Julie Hahn is our candidate.
Today I'm presenting the Bill Russell Award, and if you refer to your program, you'll see that the Bill Russell Memorial Athletic Award was donated by Mrs. Gail Russell to the graduating senior who best carries out the spirit of Bill Russell in athletics. Bill had earned 3 letters in 3 sports between the years 1951 and 1954. The requirements for this award are that the student athlete earn letters in 3 different sports, have a high achievement in scholarship, and demonstrate good citizenship and sportsmanship. This year's recipient has distinguished himself in all 3 of these areas. First of all, he is a dedicated, hardworking person who has chosen to lead by example. He carries a 2.5 grade point average and will attend Eastern Michigan University in the fall. He has also obviously earned 3 varsity letters in cross country, wrestling, and track. I'm proud to present this award to Dennis Parks.
I'm pleased to represent the Social Studies Department this morning to present the VFW Awards. The VFW Awards are in honor of those Hazel Park residents who died in the struggle in World War II. The recipients of these honors are students who have achieved a minimum of B average in all the required social studies classes, as well as electives. Besides that, they are to be students who represent the qualities of citizenship and leadership which our country stands for. The candidates to receive the awards this year have no problem meeting those standards. 2 fine young people, Steve Booth and Julie Hahn.
Good morning. I have the distinct pleasure of starting out the Music Department Awards. The first award is the Arion Award. The qualifications for the Arion Award include the contributions for the different musical organization the individual appears in, outstanding musicianship, ability to perform as a soloist, and is actually considered the top senior musician for the class of 1990. This year's candidate has been in marching band, concert band, and jazz band for 3 years. I can honestly say that this individual is one of the finest musicians I've had a chance to work here with in Hazel Park, and I can definitely put this person towards the top of my 15 years in the field of education as being outstanding. He has the ability to perform as a soloist, and sometimes that is difficult when you play on an unglamorous instrument like a tuba. Sean also has the ability to perform very well in jazz band as his fingers lick across a bass guitar, and if you ever had a chance to see him perform, you know he's very talented. He's very talented also in the vocal area. I'd like to give you the name, obviously, Sean White for the Arion Award.
I'd like to honor three choir students as the Vocal Music Award recipients. The first senior displays many qualities such as leadership, responsibility, dependability, proper attitude, and a fine singing voice. The other two winners possess two of the finest singing talents that I have ever heard in my choral program here at Hazel Park. This year's winners are Tia Lee, Martha Rasnick, and Kelly Hutchcraft.
The John Philip Sousa Award is considered the top prize in school band awards. The John Philip Sousa recognizes superior musicianship, leadership, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. This year's candidate has been an outstanding musician for 3 years in marching band, concert band, and jazz band, and also received top honors in both district and state competition. Her abilities as a leader are displayed as a band officer as they do the dirty work for the program. As far as dependability and loyalty, this person is not only dependable and loyal within the music department, but is dependable and loyal throughout all of Hazel Park High School. This person is truly a very bright, warm, and sensitive person, and I know that she has a very bright career ahead of her as she plans to attend U of M next year. And I'd like to introduce to you Nancy Ray.
Each year, the Jardon administration selects a student we feel has the greatest vocational improvement over their years at Jardon. This year, our Vocational Achievement Award goes to Kristen Laiku. Kristen has worked very successfully at Oakland General Hospital on a part-time basis and will begin working full-time at the Troy Marriott Hotel in a couple of weeks. Our congratulations to Kristen Laiku.
It is my pleasure to present the David Newberry Rotary Vocational Scholarship. To be eligible to receive this award, a student must have taken a vocational applied technical class and plan on enrolling in a vocational, trade, or technical course of study. Considerations for selection include financial need, desire, determination, interest, and achievement in a vocational technical class. This year's recipients are Patrick Bachua and James Burris. Please come forward. Patrick plans on studying machine tool technology at Oakland Community College. James plans on studying welding fabrication at Oakland Community College. Congratulations.
I'd like to invite my seniors forward. To the class of 1990, this is the senior song that this group picked out. Stairway to Heaven, I'm sure it has some semblance of meaning for you, featuring Nancy Ray and Matt Scott on the trumpet.
Assisting me is Mrs. Dale Allensworth, a member of the Hazel Park Association of Educational Office Personnel. Each year, the school district's secretarial and clerical staff award a scholarship to a student who has taken business courses, participated in the co-op program, and plans to continue his or her education in a secretarial or business field. This year's recipient has taken computer literacy, shorthand, word processing, and 3 semesters of typing. As a senior, she has participated in the office co-op program. On her co-op evaluation form, her employer gave her the highest rating possible in every category and described her as a pleasure to work with. She is a member of the Wind Ensemble, planning to attend the School of Court Reporting, Ms. Rachel Sunday.
It is with great pleasure that I represent the Hazel Park chapter of the Alpha Delta Kappa sorority. The sorority promotes charitable projects and sponsors scholarships, such as the one being given today. The phrase, a positive force in the class of 1990, is a good description of this year's recipient. Class activities, student government, National Honor Society, Language Club, Corral, and the Historical Society are but a few of the groups which have benefited from her participation. She is multi-talented, has demonstrated leadership ability, and is an extremely positive person. 4 years ago, she was a student in my creative writing class at Beecher Junior High School. Next fall, she will attend Eastern Michigan University. It is with much affection that I present the Alpha Delta Kappa Scholarship to Ms. Tia Lee.
For 20 years, the Foreign Language Club has been awarding scholarships to college-bound seniors who excel in language study. This year, the club is awarding 3 scholarships, 1 French and 2 Spanish. Mrs. Whipple will present the first 2 awards. The French student has studied for 3 years and is active in the language club. She has been a teaching assistant, working with other students to improve their skills. She plans to attend Eastern Michigan University. The outstanding French student is Ms. Sean Ku. The first Spanish award is given to a 4th-year student who started language study at Webb Junior High. He was one of 3 students who took the advanced placement test in Spanish. This diligent student completed the 4th year on an independent study basis. He will be attending Oakland University. A Spanish scholarship is awarded to Mike Grady. Mrs. Thomas is presenting the 3rd scholarship also to a Spanish student. This student was not only excelled in Spanish, but has demonstrated responsibility, enthusiasm, and appreciation for other cultures. He has been very active in the language club, and this year coordinated the club activities as the field trip chairman. Tom McCullough is a deserving recipient.
The Hazel Park Kiwanis Club is a group of people who are concerned with the special needs of this community. They search for opportunities to help people, and this scholarship is just one example of their work. Representing the Hazel Park Kiwanis Club and presenting this award is Dr. Fred Unruh. The student chosen this year to receive this scholarship award is a student who's special in many ways. To begin, the student has worked hard to obtain above average grades here at Hazel Park High. The student has been a member of the language club all 3 years. Also, this student has worked steadily for the last 2 years at part-time jobs. She has been a VICET for the last 3 years. This young lady has a profound sense of obligation and love for her family. She has a goal of attending Oakland University to become a teacher of elementary school children. With great pleasure, I present to you the Kiwanis Club Scholarship Award winner for 1990, Heather Persichini.
The Hazel Park Athletic Booster Club annually presents two scholarships to deserving senior student athletes. One unique aspect of this scholarship is that it is automatically renewable for a second year. This year's recipients are Kathleen Mulkey and Dennis Parks.
Congratulations to the class of 1990. I'd like to present the South Oakland Credit Union Scholarship Award at this time. In 1984, the South Oakland Credit Union celebrated 50 years of service in Oakland County. With this idea of service in mind, the SOC membership has provided a scholarship for a graduating senior who has generously provided to our school and their class through academic excellence and extracurricular involvement. The student receiving this award has demonstrated outstanding qualities of service through unselfish involvement working for our school community. The recipient of the 1990 SOC scholarship is Ms. Heidi Baranowski.
McAuliffe Scholarship Award was started by the Hazel Park Education Association to recognize and honor two students who have chosen the teaching profession for their career choice. It is with great honor and pleasure that I'd like to present this year's two winners. I'd like to first present the first scholarship to a very deserving young lady. She's been active in sports, the language club, the National Honor Society, and many community activities. She will be exceptional in the education field because she possesses the necessary temperament, attitude, values, and knowledge so needed to work with young scholars. Congratulations, Carrie Loftus. I'd like to present the second award to an equally deserving and outstanding young lady who has also been active in sports, the National Honor Society, and community activities. She plans to pursue her career in elementary education at Macomb Community College. Congratulations, Julie Hahn.
The young men and women seated in the front row represent this year's National Honor Society members. They exemplify the high standards necessary to become a member of this national organization. Membership is awarded to students who not only demonstrate high standards in scholarship, but are also involved in activities which show leadership, service, and character. To become a member, students must maintain a 3.25 or higher grade point average. These 23 students have not only met, but have gone far beyond that minimum. The average for this group is 3.7. All three valedictorians and three salutatorians are NHS members. Our members represent 23 of the top 32 academic students. Leadership. This group has shown its leadership in a variety of ways. One class officer and two of the BOD officers are members of NHS. This group collectively has received 57 varsity letters. They have held 12 captain positions. These members have performed in more than 25 concerts and or plays during this school year alone. Service. National Honor Society members spend countless hours helping others. We have staffed homework place with a tutor every day after school from October through May. We sang at Hazelcrest Nursing Home and collected money for children at Christmas. Our members teach music, help with Sunday school, sing or play an instrument in church choirs, and serve the community in a variety of ways. National Honor Society will be recognizing four of our members with general scholarships this year. We have three female recipients. In alphabetical order, our first young lady has a 3.3 GPA. She has served on several senior class committees and as a member of BOD and SAD. She will be attending Lawrence Institute of Technology, studying electrical engineering. Our first female recipient is Vicki Hamlin. Our next scholarship goes to a young lady who, as one of seven children, has come to our country and school to advance her future lifestyle. While here, she has not only accomplished that, but has influenced the lives of others. She has a 3.4 grade point average and is a member of SAD and Language Club. She will be attending Eastern Michigan University studying computer science. Our second recipient is Sean Koo. Our third scholarship goes to an effervescent young lady who combines schoolwork with a great deal of leadership. She has been a member of SAD, Language Club, and BOD. She will be attending Eastern Michigan University, continuing her education in the field of education. This scholarship goes to our president, Tia Lee. Our male recipient of the NHS scholarship is truly a scholar and a gentleman. His scholastic record shows a grade point average of 4.0. He is ranked first in the class. He is a soft-spoken young man, always polite, always conscientious of others. He is well-liked by his fellow students and teammates. He has received 5 varsity letters and is a team captain. He will be attending Wayne State University in the fall. Our male recipient, Tom McCullough.
It is my honor to present the Marjorie Long Scholarship Award. This year, 2 awards are being provided by the Hazel Park Parent Teacher Association. The students chosen for these awards must have demonstrated academic scholarship, been involved in extracurricular activities, had a record of volunteer services, and shown a financial need. Representing the Parent Teacher Association and giving out the awards is Mrs. Loda Van Zandt, our current district council president. While at Hazel Park High, our first recipient of this award maintained a 3.76 grade point average, was a member of the National Honor Society, and participated in baseball and tennis. He has served as a youth group leader in his church and has worked in restaurants 20 to 30 hours per week for the last 2 years. He plans to attend Oakland University in the fall. Our first recipient for the Marjorie Long Scholarship is Steve Booth. Our second recipient maintained a 3.46 grade point average, participated on the swim team, and was a very active band member during his high school career. He has served as a volunteer lifeguard at the YMCA and has worked 30 hours per week at McDonald's for the last 3 years. He plans to attend Wayne State University. Our second recipient is Bill Jones. Both names of these two students will be inscribed on the Marjorie Long Scholarship Trophy, which is permanently displayed in one of our showcases. Steve, I guess you'll have the honor of holding the trophy for the duration of the program. Thank you.
The image of your school begins with you. The image of your community begins with you. And your attitude toward life begins with you also. These words truly represent the attitude, the philosophy, and the life of Max Birchie. Most of you don't know who Max was and didn't have the honor and the privilege to know him. But this scholarship is intended to honor the memory of Max, a man dedicated as a father, a teacher, and a community leader who was committed to excellence in education and community involvement. Max Birchie loved life as he loves people. Here to present this award today is Mrs. Beverly Birchie. This year's recipient exemplifies those positive qualities that identify with Max Birchie. The desire for excellence and the skill to teach others are ever present in this young person's life. A member of National Honor Society, yearbook staff, wind ensemble, and Vikettes are only part of the things that have played an important part in this young person's life. Academics are also important, as demonstrated by a 3.63 grade point average. Dedicated leadership and teaching has led this person to pursue a career in elementary education at the University of Michigan, Dearborn. A truly charming and lovely, loving young lady, I present this award to Miss Lisa Tominello.
The Memorial Scholarship has been established in memory of former students, staff, and community members. This year's scholarship is being awarded in memory of Michael Stahaviak, a 1986 graduate of Hazel Park High School. With us to make the presentation is Mike's brother, Matthew Stahaviak. Unfortunately, medicine is not an exact science, and Mike died an untimely death during this school year. Mike was a scholar, an athlete, an involved student of fine character. This scholarship honors those qualities and reflects the mother's appreciation for aid received to send Mike to college at a class day program such as this. The family has requested that the recipient pursue a career in medicine. This student's goal is to become a pediatrician. Another qualification is the ability to succeed. Like Michael, this young lady is a member of National Honor Society and one of the top in the class. Above all, this person must be the type of person Michael was, kind, conscientious, a friend to many. The logical choice for the Memorial Scholarship is Miss Deanna Pearl. We are pleased to have Mr. Edward Kuhn with us this morning. Mr. Kuhn retired last year after 37 and a half years of teaching in the Hazel Park School District. As a social studies teacher, Mr. Kuhn attempted to instill not only facts, but also an appreciation for the democratic system and the cooperation necessary in our society. Upon his retirement, Mr. Kuhn established a scholarship for a senior of outstanding character. He knew that quite often the conscientious student goes unnoticed, but is a true asset to our school and to our country. Polite, hardworking, and dependable are adjectives that I would use to describe the recipient. He has been involved in athletics and student activities while maintaining a part-time job throughout high school. He is a very deserving young man who is planning a career in criminal justice with the goal of working for the Federal Bureau of Investigation. His student aid services in the principal's office will truly be missed. The Edward J. Kuhn Scholarship is awarded to Alan Fagan.
The American Legion Awards are recognized by the staff and administration as the second highest honor bestowed upon a senior boy and girl at Hazel Park High School. The criteria for this award include honor, courage, scholarship, and service. This year's recipients have distinguished themselves as students possessing outstanding character, gaining respect of classmates and staff. They possess courage in defining personal and academic standards for themselves and are not easily distracted. They possess outstanding leadership qualities and have demonstrated them in all facets of student life, in the classroom, in student government, and in athletics. They have achieved highest levels of academic scholarship. This is attributed partly to their desire to make learning their responsibility and have gone beyond doing lessons because they are necessary. On behalf of the staff and administration of Hazel Park High School, it gives me great pleasure to present the American Legion Awards this year to Ms. Christy Keaton and Mr. Tom McCullough.
The Wilfred Webb Award was established at Hazel Park High School some years ago to continue the spirit of a gentleman who has contributed so much to Hazel Park education. You folks in the class of 1990 probably don't know Dr. Webb too well, but those of your parents and some of us teachers who've been around for quite a while are very familiar with him. and with all the hard work that he's done as a teacher, administrator, and finally as a superintendent doing work at Hazel Park. So to commemorate that spirit of service, which was his biggest attribute and something that he always looked forward to working with kids, we'd like to present this very prestigious award, the Wilfred Wedderburn Award. The student who is the recipient of this has already been described to you, so I'm sure you will agree with me when I announce to you that she is a leader, a good student. She has commanded the respect of the faculty. It is my pleasure to award the Wilfred Wedderburn Award to Lisa Tominello.
Sometimes I think I have the best job there is, having the opportunity to get to know so many fine young people at Hazel Park High School. The bad part about it is that every June, just as you really get to know them so well, they leave. And so it is with these mixed emotions that I present the Erickson Cup, the highest honor which can be presented to a graduating senior. Certainly this year's recipient is most deserving. Her hard work, leadership, maturity, and friendly personality have made her a pleasure to work with. In fact, at times, it seems like I'm working with another staff member. She is an outstanding student, excellent leader and role model, and a fine person. But the attributes which most impress me are her people skills. She has learned to deal with people of all ages and positions in a positive, comfortable, and forthright manner. Whether it is with fellow students, teachers, administrators, or reporters, she is appropriate for whatever the situation or occasion. I have worked with her for 3 years on the board of directors and in chemistry. She has grown up and matured in so many ways, and I predict great success for her in the future. I would now like to present the Erickson Cup to Jennifer Watson. Before I actually give the cup to Jennifer, I would like to mention a couple of interesting facts about Jennifer and her family. 25 years ago this June, her mother graduated from Hazel Park High School. 50 years ago this June, Jennifer's grandmother graduated from Hazel Park High School. I guess Jennifer knows the timetable, so in 25 years, we all expect this fine tradition to continue.
Well, we've gotten to the class day, class. I've talked to you a number of times at different occasions. We had a little talk yesterday. You know what my feelings are towards you. And once more, I would like to thank you personally for the good times I've had with you. I think it's been a fun year. I hope you agree. On behalf of the faculty and the administration and all of us who work on the staff, I want to congratulate you for your achievement of graduating and for being such a fine group of students. We're very proud of you. Remember one thing, Hazel Park High School is here to help you. Even though you're not students, you're still our graduates. We still care about you. We want you to come back and see us. If we can help you in any way, please come back and look for the help that we can give you over here. Good luck to you. God bless you. I told you before, I love you. You're a great bunch of kids. And at this time, I'd like to have you all stand, and we're going to sing that alma mater the way we practiced it yesterday. So, Mr. Fisk.
Thank you.
Oh,